Have you ever wondered if you might have a urinary tract infection? I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today I'm going to talk about what symptoms may be a warning sign of a urinary tract infection for women, for men, and what are some of the risk factors for getting a urinary tract infection. If you're new here, I make videos on lots of urological education content, including bladder health, sexual health, and much, much more. So let's start with risk factors of a urinary tract infection. They generally fall into three categories. Genetic, meaning it's something that runs in your family. Behavioral, meaning it's something that maybe you're doing in your lifestyle that might be causing infections. Or lastly, biologic, meaning there's something wrong with the anatomy or with a disease process that you might have. As far as genetics, we do know that if you have a family member with a history of urinary tract infections, you're more likely to get urinary tract infections also. So biologic reasons that you can get a urinary tract infection can include having a kidney or bladder stone, having an inability to empty your bladder completely so that urine doesn't flow through the urinary tract, having some anatomic problem with your bladder or the lower part of your urinary tract, being immunosuppressed or being on medications that make it difficult for you to fight infection, or having a history of diabetes. Also, in postmenopausal women, you undergo some changes due to the lack of estrogen in your body, which can change the flora or the environment of your vagina and bladder. As far as behavioral things, there's lots of myths about this, but the three things that really do impact urinary tract infections are having sexual intercourse and not actually the person. You're not going to get it as a sexually transmitted infection, but actually having intercourse is a risk factor. The second thing is using recent antibiotics can put you at higher risk for getting infections. And the third thing is using any sort of spermicide, whether you have it in your lubricant or condoms, those things can put you at a higher risk for urinary tract infections. So you may not know this, but 60% of women present with a urinary tract infection at some point in their lifetime. And what are the most common symptoms? Usually it's pain with urination, having to go to the bathroom more often and having to go more urgently, like gotta go, gotta go. Sometimes you may also feel some suprapubic pain or pain in the lower part of your belly, or flank pain where your kidneys are located, pain on the upper side of your back. And those are what we call uncomplicated urinary tract infections. If you're having a urinary tract infection with some basic symptoms and you're a woman, it's considered uncomplicated. It becomes complicated, however, if you are immunosuppressed, if you are a man, if you have any of those anatomic problems with your bladder so that it's difficult to empty, or there's stones, though that becomes a complicated infection, or if you have any anatomic abnormality in your urinary tract, or if you develop an infection that's very resistant to multiple antibiotics. What that means is you may be at a higher risk for getting urinary tract infections, and the treatments that are offered may be less effective, or you may require a longer course of treatment. If you have a more complicated infection, you may get something like a fever or blood in the urine. And those should be warning signs that should make you go and see your primary care doctor or a urologist to get further evaluation. In men, you may have similar presenting symptoms to the ones that I described for women, but the most common symptom is urethritis or pain with urination. You may also present with kind of vague pain symptoms like pain in the pelvic region or the groin area, or sometimes in elderly men, the symptoms can be very vague, like having a little bit of altered mental status, meaning that you're not your normal self and you're kind of getting confused. You may not want to eat or drink. So it's really important, if you're not feeling like yourself or you're noticing that someone in your family who's more elderly is not acting like their normal self, that you get evaluated for the possibility of a urinary tract infection. Bottom line, if you're having any symptoms that are concerning to you, please go ahead and talk to your primary care doctor. And if you are getting recurrent infections or you have any of these risk factors for complicated urinary tract infection, please come see a urologist so we can help determine if you're having a urinary tract infection and help you get through your symptoms. Thanks so much for watching. As always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.